Everybody.
Right.
Yeah. Yeah.
Let me tell you about this show, okay? This is a show, comedy show in San Francisco, and our intention is to try to literally, purposely avoid fucking tourists. No, this is a show for Bay Area people to come, bring your swerve, have a good time, and party out, and hear some comedians!
Yeah!
Alright, fuck that wharf shit, okay? Now, I'm a native New Yorker, that's all I have to say, you know, and people like, I'm a native New Yorker and I'm fucking black, okay? And so, did you, like, really? No, and it's funny because you come to San Francisco and it's like, oh, it's so fucking cool and diverse. The only thing diverse about this town is the choice of coffee beans. I know. Has anybody here ever been in New York? You're like, what are you talking about? Where are you from?
Norway.
No, Norway? Shit. I'll tell you where I was. I'll tell you where I was last night. I was in a town called Morgan Hill.
Morgan Hill.
Has anybody here been to Morgan Hill? It's like I saw the original factory where white people were invented. I'm sitting in the car trying to get my swerve on, and I'm looking at this car, like, the walkers and the fucking signs and the blue hair, and there wasn't even a Mexican in the crowd, okay? And I was like, is that the line for the comedy show? Anyway, that's the truth. So, and I told this really like kind of trying to be a joke, racist joke, and they all knew the punchline, and they said it all. That was so fucking rough. New York guys! So, MySpace, anybody been there?
Yeah!
Isn't it funny, like, if you get fucking totally aggro and pissed at someone and you want to delete them as a MySpace friend, it's such a pain in the ass. Like, you need to know HTML to get someone out of your fucking MySpace. But whores know HTML, right? Like, you fucking bitch, ah! But I can fucking code you into another universe. That's so wrong. Julie Anderson, the DJ, what's up? That's when you go, wah, music. Anyway, Julie hosts a show. I don't know if you guys ever been to Vallejo. Speaking of ghetto. No. She hosts a show every Tuesday night called Listen and Be Heard.
Yeah, show. Right.
For this chick. It's like excellent show on Tuesday night. Julie, look at that. Everybody's got Klonopin in this crowd now, okay? Bongs. All right, I'll just tell you one quick thing, because I had this experience at work. Haven't you ever had a weekend? I don't know if anybody here has like a job that you have to go to on Monday morning. Okay. Haven't you ever had a weekend that was so jam-packed with fun that Monday morning rolls around and you think it's Sunday? Come on. All right, this happened to me the other day. I'm in so much trouble. My boss hates comedy and blah, 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 and he hates jazz, right? And so I'm like, it's Monday morning, and I totally think it's Sunday. And so I wake up, and there's a thing. It's obscure, and I just tried it for the first time, Wake and Bake. And so I totally thought it was like fucking Sunday. So I wake up, and I hadn't turned on the TV yet. I was listening to some Todd Rundgren, okay? Yes, I was, because I grew up in Long Island. I thought a baby daddy was a candy bar. Just so you get a glimpse of like what my scene is, okay? So, it's Monday morning, like, boom, boom, I wake and bake, I'm having my morning, I'm like rocking out, carry on, man! And I turned on the TV, and there was like the news and the traffic. I was like, oh my God, it's Monday. So I call my boss, and I think he's going to be cool, because he tries to, you know, people try to be cool, and they're so not, right? And so, oh, John, dude, I thought it was Sunday, so I can't do this day. Anyway, so I'm in a lot of trouble. I'm going to tell you guys how New York Nights works and why we call it New York Nights. A, it's late, and we don't give a shit. Okay? Like you guys, right?
Yeah.
The comedians come here, and they're going to say whatever they're going to say and do their thing. Give it up for the comedians! Because we have comedians who come here, they do the punchline. We have comedians here, they open for Dave Chappelle. We have like some of the best comedians in town here because they want to come because I promised them to get your party on a swerve on audience and they could say whatever they want, so I want you to stick with me. Now, you can heckle. It's Monday. You can heckle. But I don't think you want to, but if you do, then you do. Okay, is that cool? I love you. I love like the McClanahans over here. You go, girl! It's fucking cool. I tell you what, I hate work so much. I was going to talk about just finding out that my boss was gay, but there's someone in the audience that works with me, so I'm like, I'll tell that story. Right?
Too late.
You're like, too late! That fucking thing! Anyway, I did find out something about my work, is that I just found out that my coworkers, you know, you have like a team, even though they're like, hit you if it was paintball, you'd be blind, okay? Like, my team, behind my back, decided to elect me most likely to go postal.
Oh no!
That is bullshit! Fucking thing, honest, no!
Get it out.
I'm going to tell you about the show tonight. We've got like some hella comedians coming out here tonight. We got Stu Kosh, who's like crazy. I want to hear the story. Yes, she's a whore. No kidding. And so, we got Debbie Campo. This is a great show tonight. I'm just going to like not. No, I break a bong every 60 days. You rip them. Don't bitch about it for my life. Just keep it glass and don't complain. Okay. Happy Monday. So, hey Stu, are you ready to do your thing? Take your shirt off. And let's go. Let's go. Hey Stu.
Hey Stu.
Ladies and gentlemen.
Gail Epps, ladies and gentlemen.
Yeah.
Thank you for giving me the weirdest intro I've ever had.
Who the fuck was that?
Who
was
that? I don't know. I forget who it is. I think it's not
LL Cool J's,
but it's called Get Off My Dick and Tell Your Bitch to Come.
I do. I thought so, yeah. All right. Alright. I'm gonna top that. I'm gonna try. Alright, so I used to get made fun of a lot in high school. It's a little hard to believe, but I wasn't always this tall. But this one guy used to make fun of me, right? He pissed on my backpack and beat me up every day before school. Well, 3 years after I graduated, he died in a terrible drunk driving accident.
Uh-oh.
Yes! Moral of the story? Karma? No, it's don't fuck with Stu! Or I have a couple of beers and I will run your ass over! Nice to drive a jet black Camaro back in the day, I could barely see over the dash, it looked like Knight Rider just hit your fucking ass! So yeah, I am short. I'm so short I had to quit drinking because every time I bought a 40 I looked that much smaller. I'm so short, I was personating backstage passes to a Michael Jackson concert. I'm so short, there's bar stools at my house. Why? That way nobody's feet touch the fucking ground. And if being short wasn't bad enough, in high school my nickname was Stu the Jew. Because apparently, I went to an all-racist high school. Still to this day, I cannot call anybody up from high school and be like, hey man, it's Stu. Because they'll be like, Stu who? Stu the Jew. So I am Jewish. Actually, I'm Jewish Hispanic. I was adopted in Judaism, so I'm Jewish Hispanic. All it really means I'm just better able to budget my drinking problem. Being Jewish is traumatic. After getting to know my parents for 8 days, they decided they're going to chop the tip off of my significant other.
Uh-oh.
And they call it a coveting of God. I mean, Jews are so traumatized by circumcision, we wear little hats on the tops of our heads that resemble the tips of our penises in remembrance. You guys are the weirdest crowd responses ever. But that was cute. Someone awed for the guy that pissed on my backpack. When I said I'm Jewish, someone went, holla. What the fuck is that? It's not, you don't say holla to a Jew, you say holla. Awkward ass shit, man. New York Knights, man. So you guys ever been to Israel?
Oh,
yeah. Yeah, man.
Dangerous.
How about the person that said holla? You been to Israel? This person knows it's dangerous. Someone said it's dangerous, right? because there's really shitty drivers in Israel. Like, I was in Israel, and there's really shitty drivers. In fact, I was trying to cross the street, right, and this white minivan cuts me off, runs three red lights, and then goes right into an embassy and blows up. And I was like, what the fuck, bitch? You didn't see nor anything. My penis cap almost flew off the chair. See, there's a dick joke in that, at the end of that, for all the people who are into the dick, like this old lady right here. That's
cool. What?
So, I just completed a year of celibacy. Yeah, women, thanks a lot. I couldn't have done this shit without you. But before I did that, I found out I'm a father, actually. Yes, I found out very conveniently through child support services. Mother of my child had 4 kids in 4 years. She's 22 years old, 4 kids in 4 years. I don't even know what she did for the first one's birthday. It must have been something like, Christian, for your birthday, I got you a brother. Yeah, and the very best part of this gift, I made it myself. On another lighter note, I used to work at Pier 39. You guys ever go down there?
Yeah.
Tourist, of course. You gotta go down there, get an $8 churro, get a $5 refrigerator magnet. Mark that off your life's to-do list. But while I was working there, I got asked the stupidest fucking questions. Like, one day, I'm on my hands and knees scrubbing the floor, because apparently I work on a fucking pirate ship. And this guy comes up to me and he goes, I'm sorry, do you work here? And I just looked up at him and I go, no, mijo, but in my country, we have no floors. So when I see one is dirty, I must clean. And he's like, Donnie, that's how you say in your country, fuck off? Leave me the fuck alone? So, coming back from work, I saw this orange sign, black letters, that said end construction, and I thought to myself, man, people in San Francisco are protesting everything! But I don't know if you knew this, but did anybody else notice, anybody from San Francisco?
Hell yeah.
Alright, cool. Five people will get this joke. Yeah, the white person in the crowd's like, word! Chala! Alright, Muni and BART was free a week ago. If you didn't know that, that means you're not from here, or you drive. And fuck you if you drive. But Muni was free, BART was free. Not only was that cool because you got to go everywhere for free, it fucked up every homeless dude's game. Alright, like if people were coming up to me, hey man, I just need to get to Hayward, I need $3 to get to Hayward. I'm like, motherfucker, it's free! So, it's very true, man. Everything you heard here tonight is true, except for the penis thing on the yarmulke, because somebody came up to me after a show and was like, I never knew why Jews wore those hats on their heads. That's so interesting. People are very cultured in San Francisco. All right, well, that's my time. Thank you very much. Give it up for Gail Epps. Silence falls like a fucking still monster. Okay, listen. Our next comedian coming to the stage is a black guy. He's really funny. He's a local San Franciscan. His name is Philip K. Watson. And I want you to whoop it up for him, for Philip K. Watson, right now. Thank you. Yeah.
You are performing after all.
Yo.
You're live.
Comedy college.
Yeah.
If I could only finish this college, you know, that would be nice, wouldn't it? Gosh. I'm actually working towards my doctorate here. You don't say. Anyways, everyone's well tonight, I hope. You feeling good?
Yeah.
Woo! It's got some energy here. Oh. You know, it's a trip, man. This place, This reminds me of the free clinic, sort of. Oh. And just the chairs, the way it's set up and everything, you know? Seriously. You can probably pick up at the free clinic too, man. Have you ever been at the free clinic and you're seeing somebody at the free clinic, you're like, hey, you got what I got? Can I get what you got? You want what I have? I like your rash. Those people come with them. I don't know, this is the times we live in, man. Like, I was outside, right? And I see this canine unit, this cop. And the dog was in the back just licking his package. Just licking, though. He was like in the zone. He was just smacking and stuff. I'm like, what the heck is it? Is this where tax dollars are going? What's your badge number, man? And then the dog, he turns around and he teabags me. He's just like, I'm like, what the? Who? What? What's your badge number? He turns around okay. Hey, it's all right, people need to laugh at these jokes. I won't be offended. It's a trip, man. Golly. No, I'll take the sympathy fund. I'll take the sympathy fund at that moment. You know, sometimes I do this stuff, this comedy stuff, and I get no reaction, seriously. And sometimes I get rhythm, you know, whatever. And it's like flirting with lesbians, you know what I'm saying? Sometimes you think you might be able to win, you know? You flirt with lesbians, you're like, what's up? He's like, it must be my cologne. So, what are we doing later? Burning pictures of men. Oh! All right. Must be my cologne. Anyways, yeah. It's a trick. Any weed smokers?
Yeah.
No weed smokers? Two weed smokers in San Francisco. The end of the world is near. Two weed smokers. I don't know. The weed is awful strong. You smoke a little bit, and it just takes you to this other level where you're just wandering on freeways 3 days later, you know what I'm saying? And people are honking at you, you're just like, what? What's happening? It's turning into some Miles Davis cool jazz. You're like, help me, man! People melting into teddy bears and shit, like, no!
You can see that?
No! Yeah. Give me another hit, man. Yeah. Outside. No, I'm just kidding. So, George Bush. You guys into George?
Yeah.
Come on, where my Republican hat? Republican Party? Come on. Yeah, George Bush, man. We need to change this Constitution, get him 4 more years, baby. What's up with that? Come on, Party of Lincoln, somebody? Nobody, okay. You guys are just mad because he's not sharing his cocaine, okay? You know he has the best cocaine, too. He has like some serious, like pharmaceutical grade A cocaine. You know what I mean? That type of coke, you do one line and this laps into a cocaine rage. And you're just like, burn down Nicaragua. Excuse me? Pardon me, sir? You heard what I said. Burn Nicaragua to the ground! General, have some more cocaine. You are the man, brother! Anyways, you're really going to enjoy this show. It's a really hot show, and the comedians just get better and better and better. Thank you for letting me hang out with you. But let me leave you with this, okay? You guys were almost like, thank goodness! Finally! Let's spread love, okay? Summer of love, official, alright? This now means I love you. New Millennium, come on now, hold it up. Yes, love the one you're with. Yes, come on, hold it up. Thank you, brother. Come on, higher, higher, yes! Yes! You guys are just like, no. No. Come on! Love her, man, at least, alright!
Yeah!
Thank you, everybody. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome your host back. Thank you, Gail.
Yeah.
Watson Rose was talking about this. Philip K. Watson, give it up for the Negro. What's going on?
Yeah. Woo.
Our next comedian coming to the stage is a petite Asian flower. Give it up for a sense. what do you call that thing that white people do that looks like square dancing? River dancing! A river dancing! Petite Asian flower. Please give it up. But white people, I thought white people did the river dance. I don't know. No, Skippy McClellan is angry with me. Well, the river dance, the fleekity flack, I'm from Long Island. I know Mahjong and I know drugs.
Michael Flatney.
What?
Hey, I should be your assistant.
You are my assistant.
I love you.
I love you, too. What is love? It's abstract. Give it up! No, I mean really give it up. Give it up. Well, here we are celebrating the birth of our nation. Unfortunately, we're still in the war in Iraq, if you can call it that. You know what we look like? I mean, we went over there, we were looking for what? Biological, chemical, and weapons of mass destruction. You know what we look like to the other countries of the world? We look like Geraldo Rivera in Al Capone's vault.
Yeah, right on.
Thank you. Now, it's been in the news, one of the Beatles is getting a divorce, Paul, the cute Beatle, and everyone's going, oh, she was a gold digger. That's what they say in the tabloids. Hmm. And he said, no, it's not because of that. It's because she has a bad temper and because she keeps telling me to get plastic surgery.
Hmm.
And I thought, gee, everyone has misjudged this poor woman. How do you know? Maybe Sir Paul McCartney walks around his castle hitting his wife with zingers like, hey, Heather, why don't you grow a leg?
Hell yeah.
You know, I usually like to wear the fanny pack. I hate these fucking fashion experts on TV, right? And this woman's going, what could be worse than a fanny pack? And they wear it right in the middle of their stomachs. I'm thinking to myself, yeah, but if you're outside walking around San Francisco and someone tries to stab you in the abdomen, you're protected.
Yes.
You know all those you know, races they have that women run for charity, like breast cancer and shit? Well, you know, I'm too fat to run in that. So I was a volunteer, right? So they gave me...
Awesome.
I had to do fucking something, dude. So my job was to sit at the first aid table and pass out bandages to women who got blisters. And I said, well, what else? They go, and you should cheer the women on. And I go, like, what should I say? They said, like, you go, girl, you can do it. And I was so conflicted about that job because there I sat, they had run 16 miles, and there I am sitting, eating a fucking donut, fat, going, yeah, you go, girl, you can do it. And you know they were thanking me? I ate before I came here. I had American food. You know what I hate about American food? You eat it and 3 hours later, you're still full. I think that's one of the reasons I decided to become a vegetarian. You know, it's very PC to be a vegetarian, and we always have to qualify what kind of vegetarian we are. Well, I'm a vegetarian, but I eat seafood. Well, I'm a vegetarian, but I take dairy. Well, I'm a vegetarian, but I eat bacon and sausage. Being a vegetarian, I lost 15 pounds. I realized I was getting kind of fat when I would bend over and my pantyhose would rip up the middle. I didn't need the cotton cross to breathe. I had a big gaping hole.
Oh my.
I haven't always been a comic. 15 years ago, I was going to be a nun. But the day I was going to check into the convent, it dawned on me. I can't be a nun. I'm a slut. Now, in case you're wondering, Chua is a Chinese name. Now, I have one question for all the round-eyed people in this room. Why is it all you round-eyed people are such shitty drivers? I think it's because you got too much peripheral vision. It's distracting. You're bombarded by too many images on the side. Why do you people have to look over your shoulders when you're pulling out of the driveway? That's what the horn's for. And why do you look over your shoulders when you're changing lanes? We Asians know when to change lanes without even looking.
Yep.
When it feels right, do it. We meditate. It's the Zen of driving, and I invented it. Now, any of you women out there read any of those self-help books for women in self-destructive relationships, like women who love too much, women who love too often, women who come too soon? But I didn't have time to read all those books. So I read the cliff notes. You know what it said? Stop getting dicked around, stupid. I'm coming out with my own book, guys who put out in San Francisco and their phone numbers.
Yeah!
You know how you can tell when you've been in a relationship too long? When you look at your partner and you think to yourself, why can't he be somebody else?
Oh, no.
Anybody else? Carrot Top. Jerry Springer. Howard Stern. Hey, come on, there's a real man for you. How much do you want to bet Howard has Jerry back? Are men with hairy backs the counterpart of women with hairy nipples? Just something for you to contemplate in your hot tubs.
Yes.
And now we've come to the sensitive part of my act. Woo! I have something I'd like to share with you. I was in an abusive relationship, but then I got tired of beating up the same guy. By applause! How many people here think men are just a tad egocentric? Really? You go out with them once and it's, she wants a relationship. So now I just give it to them right off the bat. I want a relationship. I need a commitment from you now. I want to have your baby. And then they get off the bus. Hey, that's my time. I'm testing you. Thank you. There's a black guy here.
Hey!
Yeah!
Okay, now you're coming to a comedy show, you want to see some Negro? Get out!
This room.
Yeah!
Woo! Hey, Greg! Hey! I'll tell you, boy, I love San Francisco. I walk in the rooms and get hugged by white women. And it's great. It's great. It's an awesome place.
Other than your girlfriend?
Well, let me introduce myself before I start revealing too much. My name is Greg Edwards. I'm an actor and a comedian, so that means I don't have a job. That's right. I'm broke. I don't have a car, man. I noticed that it's kind of hard arguing with your girlfriend if you don't have no means of transportation. You get on my nerves, girl! Can't give me a ride to Bart? Please. I love women, man. I love women a whole lot, just like as you may have heard already. the best thing about women to me are menstrual cycles. That's right. I think menstrual cycles are kind of cool, but for real, I'm sorry. I know I don't have to go through it. I still think it's cool, though. No, I like them. But you know the coolest thing about menstrual cycles? For real, like, you got a best friend, right? You got a best girlfriend or something? Oh, right over there. See, like, and y'all hang together, and y'all are real tight. Like, the girls, if they hang real tight together, their menstrual cycles get magnetized by the moon, and it comes on at the same time, right?
So then you stay away from that week or what?
Exactly. But see, I wish that would happen to guys. You know, like if you hung out with me for a long time, you get a big dick. That's gonna be crazy.
She did lots of friends.
Just my thoughts, people. My thoughts. You know what else I like about women? Women like to shop. Women like buying shoes and stuff, man. And I like buying shoes too, you know. But it is one shoe store that I will never shop at, and that is Athlete's Foot.
Athlete's Foot.
I just think that's stupid. How are you gonna name a shoe company after a foot disease? You know what I mean? That's like me going to a chicken restaurant called Salmonella Sandwiches. It's like me going to McDonald's on Mad Cow Mondays. Mexicans buying books from Borders. That's me ashamed for laughing at this terrible humor. You got any Monopoly fans in here?
Yeah. The shoe.
You like the shoe? Man, I'm gonna ask you this, since you like the shoe. Man, if I play Monopoly with my Asian friend, does he automatically get the car? All right. Well, if I'm playing Monopoly with a Mexican family, do they all get the car? Or if I'm playing Monopoly with myself, do I steal the car? I like being racist all the way around. Aww. I'm not racist. I'm like a fruit racist. Everything is racism, man. Everything has to do with race, y'all. I'm telling you. Look, I was washing clothes the other day, and I realized that washing clothes is very racist. I mean, check it out. The white clothes get the hot water. The color clothes get the cold water. The white clothes get their own separate loan. The color clothes get kicked all together. Blues, blacks, reds. I've been reds about them lately. And if one of them color clothes get caught in that white batch, uh-oh. That nigga's going to jail. Just my thoughts, people.
Or else they're all colored.
Uh-oh, yeah, that's true. Yeah, he's fine then. That's right. Have the community with your crack cocaine. That's right, that's what we do. Anybody smoke weed?
Yeah.
Uh-oh, I see this thing all over here. Like the smoke just went all right over here. Look, California has like the best weed in the country. Weed smokers, am I right?
Yeah.
Yes. That's right. If your kid is born in California, your kid is born with hair, an umbilical cord, and an eighth of weed. That's right. And if you live in California, you don't need a girlfriend. No, because California has, you know, weed has the same effects on men that women have on. It gets you fat, it slows you down, and you never can remember what happened all your month. And you can tell the bad effects of drugs by just watching the effects it's had on our presidents. I mean, check it out. JFK was an alcoholic. He fucked Marilyn Monroe. Bill Clinton smoked weed, and he fucked the secretary. George Bush did coke. And he fucked up the whole country. Hey, that's my name. My name is Greg Edwards, y'all. That's my time. Thank you very much.
Baker. Our next comedian. comedian coming up to the stage is white.
Wow.
See, nobody gives it up. Like, give it up for this one. No, never. You don't have to or anything. He's a native San Franciscan, and this guy knows more about San Francisco. That has nothing to do with your act, I'm sure. It's so awesome that anyone I know, you know, all these, like, you go to these little alleys and he's like, whoa, that's where the first crack whore. He's a member of the Stand-Up Project, which is an amazing troupe of comedians who actually hooks up in here, whoa, every Saturday night at 10 o'clock. The Stand-Up Project, cool show, one of the stalwart characters, not like a white word, but blah, blah, blah characters in the Stand-Up Project, a very funny guy and a white guy. Please give it up for Mr. Tom Smith, right here.
Hey everybody, let's hear it for Gail Epps, your host and MC.
Hey Gail!
She just did about 3 of my minutes. Let's hear it for her, God bless her. Yeah, I guess, am I the first white person up here? Is that what that was?
What the fuck do
you mean? Wow, Jesus Christ. Was that you?
No.
Oh.
No, I...
Woo! Yeah, you...
Well, that's okay.
Oh, okay. That's cool. Oh, that's all right, man. I sometimes feel bad about it myself, so don't worry about it.
I get a little excited sometimes.
Me too. And frankly, you're helping with that. By the way, this looks like a trial for the fucking real world here. What happened here, man? Jesus Christ, dude. So I'm doing this thing right now called Practicing Celibacy, also known as Match.com. Beautiful. For $45 a month, and I'm still masturbating. What a great idea that is. In fact, I remember thinking to myself all those years, hey, what's this experience missing? A monthly fee. That's sweet, man. Weird day. I tried some new stuff on you guys because I love you. So I was at the post office earlier today, and I was in line, and this woman in front of me got done with her business, and she stopped. She got done, and she turned to the person behind the counter, and she said, "Wow, you are really helpful. I don't care what anybody says about the post office." Yeah. Here's why that's a really fucking bad idea. You know one of the things they also say about the post office? People who work there carry guns and kill people who annoy the shit out of them. All right, cool. Yeah, told you it was new. That's all right. My God, it's been a weird sort of year. My brother is a redneck. By the way, I didn't know this. Rednecks. I live over in Oakland right now. I did not know they let rednecks into Oakland. Do you know that? It's no shit, man. I was walking along the Lake Merritt one night, and this truck drives by, and it's not so much a truck as it is a giant chrome penis enlargement on four wheels.
Yeah.
And this guy leans out the window and says to me, "You look like a Jew." I look kind of like I ate a Jew.
Where'd that first comedian go anyway?
What's up? Up your ass in a second, Sparkles. Are you fucking with me, sir? I don't know, who was the first comedian? Oh, that was Gail. Anyway. Yeah. This is interesting. You guys are hardcore. What's it like, you fucking drinking it or something? All right, let's talk about something controversial for a second. 9/11. Thing, huh? Heroes of 9/11. There's a whole group of heroes of 9/11 that I don't think are getting enough play. Here's what I mean. Because when you think of the heroes of 9/11, what do you think of the firemen and the policemen and all like that? And that's cool, and you should. But there's a whole group of people who are just getting totally ignored. You know who that is? Fucking office temp. Yeah, think about that. An office temp in those towers making $7 an hour. You're up there doing data entry going, God damn, this sucks. How could this get any fucking worse? I'm telling you, man, they're just not getting enough credit, you know? I have an idea, because I want my office, because I'm an office head, it makes a lot of sense to me. I've got an idea for a memorial for them. Be a giant bronze toner cartridge. On the side it says, "I remember what's his face."
Sweet.
No, dude, I'm real poor right now, but I'm not worried about that because I just opened up an account at Coinstar.
Coinstar.
What? You guys know what I'm talking about. It's a really young crowd, man. Shit. Don't get into all my Hogan's Heroes references.
No, come on.
Oh, shit, man. You're Hogan's Heroes, man. Think about that. How many of you guys are familiar with that goddamn show?
He is.
He is, all right. We got one person. Well, this joke's for you, brother. What a weird fucking concept.
I'm going to make Hogan's Heroes jokes all night.
All right, well, here you go, brother. Banner up. Let's go. Dude, Hogan. Here's the thing, Hogan's Heroes, man. Like, what? It's a movie about a POW camp run by hilarious Nazis. Who the fuck came up with that idea?
Yeah,
I want to be on the pitch session on that one. Hey, I got a great idea for a show. You're gonna love it. It's gonna be called It's the Killing Field Show. You're gonna follow the last English teacher in Cambodia as he tries to make his way out of the country before being killed. All right, you don't like that one. How about this one? Hutu's the boss. All right, cool. Hey, man, you ever have like friends that are so rich you go to their house and it's like the set of Less Than Zero? You walk in there and it's like people with this much money have got to be living some kind of horrible deviant lifestyle. Behind closed doors, you know, like that. Oh, you see, you like that couch? Well, it's actually made from the authentic skins of Honduran babies. Yeah, take a seat right there and check it out. Come out Thursday. We're gonna have our every week me and my friends get together and we have our annual bridge and fisting party. Check it out. Monica's gonna be bringing her tamale pie. So. All right, cool. It's weird. I don't know if you guys could figure this out. I've got actually a number of insecurities. Well, you can tell that by looking at me. No, Tom, with that eating disorder, who could have guessed? But it's true. I have some weird insecurities. One time, this is actually a true story. One time I was actually in the middle of getting a BJ, and the thought occurred to me, hey, I think she does like me. Follow that? All right, cool. All right, anyways, yeah, I do live over in Oakland right now, which is weird. I live on Lake Merritt. Some weird stuff over there. There's a place over there actually called the Casket Outlet. Wow. They have a store. It's a casket fucking outlet store. I was wondering what, like, the high-pressure salesman technique would be at the Casket Outlet. Hey, how's it going? See, you really know your caskets. That's a sweet little number right there. That actually started off as a wardrobe from IKEA. We got a bargain on that. I'm going to pass those savings on to you. One question only. What's it gonna take to get you into one of these caskets today? Sweet man. My brother's a redneck. He's such a redneck, he actually lives in Reno, Nevada. Holy shit. I got to open for him, actually, one night. I went up and opened for him, because he's in a band, because he's a bassist, and I'm a stand-up comic, which means pretty much the Smith Boys have given up on pussy, ever. That's what that comes out to. But anyway, so I got to open for his band, and it was like, I swear to God, I got to open, I got to do comedy at a biker bar in a strip mall in Carson City, Nevada. Quite frankly, that's how I pictured the end of my career. Wrap up that set, head on down to Motel 6 and curl up with a nice shotgun. Sweet. He is, my brother, my God, my brother is such a redneck, he actually drives an El Camino. Holy shit, think about that. An El Camino. The thing is, he's done a lot of work on it, and it's the world's only four-wheel drive ashtray. Sweet. He's wanted me to move up to Reno, Nevada, but I can't do that. Because again, I talked about this before, but I don't know if you can tell this. Impulse control is not something I do well. And every single one, and I mean every one, of my shitty impulses cater to specifically in Reno, Nevada. Mandatory smoking everywhere. $3 all-you-can-eat buffets, yeah. Prostitution's legal. Oh, fuck. Within a year, my friends would be having the following conversation. Hey, did you hear about Tom? Yeah, but what a great last day he had. Managed to kill a couple of cartons of Marlboro Red, went on down to a buffet. He actually drank an entire steam pan full of country gravy. Went and nailed three hookers, and his lifestyle was so unhealthy that he actually ejaculated sausage links. Didn't pass away so much as his heart fled his body and joined Al-Qaeda in protest. Yeah, I wouldn't last very long up there, dude. I was up, Jesus Christ, I'm doing like some weird shit. I don't know, have you guys ever heard of a place called Modesto, California?
Yeah,
what a shithole that place is. Modesto, California, they got, every town in California, by the way, has a motto. I didn't know if you knew this. Town motto of Modesto is, water, wealth, contentment, health. And that's bullshit, because what it should read is, water, wealth, contentment, health, bail bondsman. Because that's like a cash crop in that shithole of a town. Another one I really hate, if you get a chance to go to Eureka, don't do that either. Because Eureka's where National Socialism meets hot dog on a stick. That's Nazis, for those of you who didn't laugh. But anyway, Eureka, town motto of Eureka is, Eureka, it's all right here. Yeah, that's low self-esteem as a civic concept. What got left on the cutting room floor with that one? Eureka, fuck it. Eureka. That was awkward. Well, thanks, Malcolm. Everybody, let's hear it from Malcolm Grissom. Thank you.
I'm so confused. Like Modesto? What the fuck? Hello? Where's that? It's bread. I've learned Hanukkah. I know there's a punchline that's going to say that. Meanwhile, our next comedian coming up to the stage is going to rip it up. He's one of my favorites. Hello? Yeah, my mood ring says fuck. And it's a really funny guy. First saw him at the punchline. Cracks me up, and I want you to give it up because he's really funny, animated, yeah. All that stuff you like, for Mr. Chris Garcia.
What's up, everybody? How you doing?
Good, good.
Did I suck on the way up or something? How's it going over here? What's up? What's up, Indie Rock? How you guys doing?
Fucking hipsters!
Yeah, fucking hipsters.
I like your sweater.
Thanks. Really?
I hate hipsters.
My mom, oh, you're totally not a hipster in those Converse All Stars. Just kidding. Moving on. Jackblack.com over there. Okay. Did you see that yet? Not so good. Anyone see it yet?
No.
Okay, good. Let's move on to my actual set. Awesome. Okay. I was reading that, what's that newspaper where the homeless people write the articles?
Oh,
yeah, the Chronicle. And there's that story about the Duke lacrosse team. Have you ever read about that yet? We haven't.
Rapinch?
Yeah, exactly. The Duke lacrosse, Duke University lacrosse team, gang raped a stripper.
Oh.
You hear about that?
Allegedly.
Allegedly racist. And they think it's racially motivated because the strippers were African American. And no, so far not that much has happened to fix it. Can you imagine if it was the other way around, a bunch of black dudes did that to a white stripper, what the reaction would be? Be like, what the fuck are those black dudes doing? Playing lacrosse! I hate the news. Like when the weather was bad this year, Crom is always trying to scare us. They're like, is San Francisco ready for Katrina? Oh, I think we are. If that shit were dropped here, the whole Castro would turn into a big-ass pool party. Look at Trina, you're a tranny, blowing boys in the alley. Like all the bottles from the bars be floating down the street this way. It'd be old Chinese ladies recycling the bottles this way. All the bottles would be fucked, the beauty would be fucked. The only thing perfectly intact would be Gavin Newsom's hair. That shit is weatherproof. Anyone go to Gay Pride last week? H&M?
Yeah!
I went in a... Boo. What is that? Boo?
Yeah!
For H&M or boo against how gay H&M is?
H&M.
Okay, that's pretty boo sauce. It's pretty sucky, but I actually, I went to Gay Pride, and I saw my friend Ryan rollerblading around, and he rollerbladed right up to me, and he was like, dude, I just made out with a guy. Does that mean I'm gay? I was like, nah, psh, you rollerblades mean you're gay. And then I raised the scooter away. I was like, see ya. I don't know if you saw the news today, but this happened today. Some NBA basketball player was arrested for drunk driving. Do you hear about this? This dude was drunk driving. He was arrested for not only drunk driving, but drunk driving while he was masturbating.
Eddie Griffin.
Eddie Griffin. On the table. And I was like, yo, man, I can't, like, so, let the man live the dream, you know what I mean? But, I can understand, because sometimes I can't wait to get home to get drunk. I mean, that's like masturbating in your own car. That's awesome. I wish I could do that in my own car. For now, I'll stick to my bicycle. They both involve helmets. Okay, it's a new joke. Maybe I'll do that one again. Maybe not. Okay. Was that? It's rad that he did that, right?
Yeah.
Isn't that crazy? I read that. I was like, what?
So rad.
I bet you his dick was hanging out the window by like 4 feet. That guy's like 7 feet tall.
Totally. Sorry.
I'm Cuban. Hold your applause. Yeah, are you Cuban?
Hell yeah.
Are you serious? What's up,
Raph.com?
Are you Cuban?
We're, She's all alike.
No, she's not.
We call her Cuban, yeah.
Really? What, are you like, are you the first person in your family born here?
Yeah.
Really?
No, I was born.
See, I'm number one. That's cool.
I got brothers.
How old?
32.
What year did they get here?
One of them did the music for Kingdom of Heaven.
Can you repeat that again for me? I can't even sit down in public. I just sit down like this. I'm in public. Kingdom of Heaven. I know I'm not her brother, dude. This is how I sit. Oh. I see it. That's just like a white person always taking a Latino's job. How wasted are you? Are you pretty wasted?
What?
Are you pretty wasted? Or do you just have scoliosis? I'm not drunk. I have no spine. Oh. Well, that's because you're yelling out. Somehow that's my time. Enjoy the rest of your evening. Chris Garcia!
Awesome!
Good job on the mic there, buddy.
Chris Garcia! Alright, well, the DJ over there playing her song like she got an attitude, right? We're gonna bring her up on the stage.
Yeah!
So that's it from the DJ, little white girl from Vallejo. How's that for you? Okay. Is she white?
I'm trying to keep track,
but you know, DNA speaks for itself. Give it up for her.
Okay.
The one and only Julie Anderson.
Thank you. How's it going? I'm just waiting for you guys to exhale because I ran out of weed this week.
Yeah!
Did you fuckers give it up?
Yeah!
You guys had a good time?
Yep.
You got the bottle of how much have you finished off on that?
Is
that Captain Morgan?
We've been watching Queer as Folk all day.
Yeah. You've been watching Queer as Folk? What is that? What's Queer as Folk? A show. I don't have television.
No, I don't either.
You guys are having a good time, that's cool.
Yeah!
You're going to feel like hell tomorrow, let me tell you that.
We're here for you!
Oh, thank you! Well, so, you know, Gail said I live up in Vallejo. You know, like on the sign when you pull in, it says City of Opportunity. And that's really true. It's an opportunity to get crack at wholesale prices.
Yeah.
Got the cheapest gas in California, you know that? We pull you in with that gas price, and then we take your wallet. Thank you, guys. Yeah! No, what I love about Vallejo, though, is it's urban, but not so urban that it's really scary. Let me just explain it to you. I get the Vallejo Times Herald because I need the rubber bands. And I went out to get my newspaper about a week ago. And I, you know, 7:30 in the morning, I'm going down to get my newspaper and lean down to get it. And right next to it on the sidewalk, dime bag of weed. I looked up and I said, today, Vallejo loved me back. I had just resubscribed to the newspaper, so I thought, well, maybe it's a new incentive program. That's cool. But see, that's, you know, and then I thought, well, you know, maybe I should turn it into the proper authorities. Hey, what's up?
Sorry.
Who's calling?
I have no idea.
Oh, your mom. You got to give me
answer it.
Give me that.
It's like sex in the
city. Yeah, it's like
answer it.
Hello?
Answer it.
Hello, is no, this isn't Richie. Does it sound like Richie, goddammit?
Oh my god, I'm so mad at this
problem. No, actually, Richie actually left his phone on during a comedy show.
Insist for this labor imitation. Buy from reputed dealers only.